Thank you very much for giving us opportunity to present our work in Women in Bioinformatics and Data Science LA Conference. The topic of today's poster presentation is affinity prediction between cosmetic ingredients and CD54-CD86 receptors by molecular docking, a novel approach to predict skin sensitization potential. I am Ms. Ritushri Biswas from Annotation Analytics, the company located in Gurgaon, India. I have done this work with my colleague, Ms. Sarah Akrami, Ms. Anne Nicole, and Mr. Sunil Jayant. To begin with, I would very first like to define the term skin sensitization. Skin sensitization is defined as allergic response to a substance after skin contact. We describe age-clad method where cosmetic compounds interacts with dendritic cells and express two biomarkers, CD54 and CD86, if compound is a sensitizer. Our objective is to achieve significant reduction of time and cost for large-scale cosmetic screening. And for that, we aim to develop in silico skin sensitization prediction model to assess interaction between cosmetic compounds and CD54 and CD86 receptors. In our method, we used molecular docking approach to find interaction of the cosmetic compounds with the CD54 and CD86 receptors. We took CD54 and CD86 protein structures from RCSB data bank and selected 6 positive and 3 negative chemicals with known skin sensitization effect from 442E H-CLAT OECD guidelines. Our docking results revealed that positive cosmetic ingredients, that is diphenylcyclopropanone, phthalic anhydride, tetramethylthioidium disulfide and isoeugenol showed strong affinities for CD54 and CD86 receptors. Compounds like benzyl benzoate and oxalic acid showed moderate affinities for CD54 and CD86 receptors. Negative skin sensitizers, lauric acid and heptyl butyrate showed weak affinities against CD54 and CD86 protein receptors. Thus, we can conclude our computational results present the proof of concept of in silico method where positive sensitizers make strong affinities with receptors than negative sensitizer compounds. And also, in silico screening can be combined with in vitro method to reduce cost of pre-screening of compounds and get alert for sensitization potency of compound, which will be validated by later in vitro experiment. Thank you everyone for your attention, and I would acknowledge Annotation Analytics for all the support, and I would also like to thank my co-workers. Thank you.